daughter said to me recently, Mom, you always have so much knowledge. You always have answers for most things about life that other people don't even know about. You should be doing like TED Talk on things like that. And I said, no, I don't. I don't know anything. I'm just a student of life, but who's really curious to know. And I figured out that the little I'm able to share with others actually allows me to learn much more. This is my default setting. You give a little and you're blessed with so much more. My name is Sylvia Michetti and this is Luminosity TV. Do you believe that true knowledge is readily available, but only to those who are ready for it? Do you believe that you can speak with 500 people in an audience and your words are meant for just one? That one person who has been waiting to hear those exact words. The others, however, they're just supporting acts, backup crew. And oftentimes I've had people send me messages saying that a particular video I made was speaking directly to them. And I will always respond by saying, well, I made it just for you. I believe that not until you are ready and in alignment vibrationally with something, will you be able to fully grasp it. Otherwise, it will never make sense to you. It will never make its way to you. And because of this, we might all be on the same planet, but each of us is living a different reality based on our comprehension of what reality means. So you need not fight with anybody. You need not argue with anyone. You need not try to convince anyone or be upset that they're not on the same wavelength as you. You have to see that that's where they're at and that's their level on the reality spectrum. And no matter how much you try, you can't push them up. No matter how much you love them, you can't move them any faster on that ladder. I always say that if an alien abducted two people on Earth this very minute and say, well, can you tell me what the Earth is like? I would like to know. The Earth that you will describe will be so different from my version of the Earth based on my experiences. So much so that the alien will be wondering like, how is it that these two people live on the same planet? So some people are floating their boat and some have already sunk their boat. So how can you explain to somebody whose boat has sunk already? You know what? My boat is so beautiful. It makes me very happy. When I'm in my boat, ooh, I feel alive. I'm so grateful to the good Lord for my boat. They can't comprehend it. They'll be looking at you like, what's wrong with this one? But that's because the only reality they can perceive at the moment is one of a sunken boat. So those times when it feels like you're living a different reality from those around you, those that you call friends and family, and you sometimes feel misunderstood, like you're operating from a different page. Yes, you are. That's because your reality is different. They can only comprehend based on their level of understanding, and you can't change that for them. Not until they themselves are ready. And until then, just remember to be empathetic and be more understanding and know that it is possible that they may never be ready, but that's not your fault. And a lot will be offered, but it is based on their own readiness. So you can offer two people the exact same value and one will take it as crap because, well, they can't comprehend it. They don't understand it. And yet for the other person, it's all they've been waiting for. It's like they found a pot of gold at the end of a rainbow. And so the saying that when the student is ready, the teacher will show up is so right. Or as Rumi will say, as you start to walk on the way appears. So for those we love dearly, whom we tend to worry so much about, let us take consolation in the knowledge that there's no one who's truly seeking that won't find at the end of the day that which they're looking for. The question is, are they ready for it? And I remember this from my own experience about 4 or 5 years ago when a guy came to my house with another dear friend of mine and he was talking about healing the body with herbs and eating more living foods that would help your body heal, rather than the conventional way of eating and medicine that suppresses our symptoms and taking pills and all of that. At that time, even though I knew deep down that everything he was saying was right, I wasn't ready to admit that to myself. I was so hooked on the idea that I needed an expensive doctor for all of my health solutions. And I couldn't even comprehend the idea of herbs. So I suffered more health issues, just like he told me I would, until I was ready. And when I was ready to put only natural herbs in my body, I would go hours on the train just to be able to go and buy those herbs. And it meant so much to me at the time. I would do it so happily. And this is because the universe always puts these things in our faces so that eventually, when we are ready and we are seeking for it, it will find us again. And I've since healed myself with so many herbs, and I've found so much health benefits from nature. There's help all around us 24/7, whether it be for those seeking spiritual knowledge, for those with health issues, for those with financial solutions, for those wanting meaningful relationships, finding their partners, whatever it is that we are looking for, it is always available and reachable. But your preparedness, your readiness to see that which is offered, that is what actually hinders a lot of people from getting what they want. They can't see it. And creation is ever loving, ever giving. So be ready to give yours a little bit as well, however little that you have to share. And be gentle with those who can't comprehend what you embody, who can't make sense of why you are the way you are, why you do the things that you do, why certain things are important to you than other things, why you feel fulfilled when you, in the little things, you find fulfillment in the little things, and you go, wow, you know. And then when the big things come, you say, okay. Meanwhile, they need the big things before they can be wowed. We might all be swimming in the same sea, but some swim upstream, making it so difficult for them to get to the shore where happiness awaits them, while others just choose to calm down and swim downstream and go with the flow of the water. And thus they find happiness and fulfillment in the end. So when people come into your life and you find yourself explaining your position and trying to justify who you are to them and the knowledge with which you stand, don't bother. It's pointless exercise. It will only be meaningful to those who are ready. And for those who are not, no matter how much you tell them or say to them, they will never hear anything. They will hear nothing at all. So let your thoughts, your words, and your actions always breathe life, so that those who are truly alive will find benefit from you. Until next time, take good care. Bye for now.